Well, welcome to my channel. Today I will be discussing about grade 10 biology and topic is flowers parts or parts of flowers. Now let us understand different parts of flowers and some terms related to it. So this flower is basically designed for sexual reproduction. Let us understand the sexual reproduction. What is the meaning of it? Sexual reproduction takes place by special reproductive cells called as sex cells. These cells are also called as gametes, and there are two types of gametes, male gamete and the female gamete. Now in sexual reproduction, the male gamete fuses with the female gamete to form the zygote. This zygote which is formed gives rise to new organism. We have to note here that the gametes always have half the number of chromosomes, and when they two unite, they the half number they combine and they create the full number of chromosome in an organism. So gametes are those cells which have half the number of chromosomes in them. Let us see next slide. Sexual reproduction in flowering plants. Flowering plants are also called as angiosperms because of the two characteristics. First, they have sex organs they carry within the flower, and second, the seeds which are formed, they are enclosed inside the fruit. So because of these two characteristics, they are grouped under angiosperms. Now the flowering plants reproduce by sexual method, and these flowers, there are two types of flowers observed. Some of the flowers have both male as well as female reproductive organ inside it. Such flowers are called as bisexual flowers. Example is hibiscus and mustard. Other type of flowers are those flowers which have only one, either male or female reproductive organ inside it. They are called as unisexual flowers. For example, papaya or watermelon. Now, what is the function of flower? Function of flower is formation of male and female gametes, and second, fertilization of these gametes to form the seeds, and the seeds will give rise to new plants. So let us see next slide. Steps of sexual reproduction. How the seeds are formed, that we will understand. Male organ is called as stamen. There is a male organ in a flower is called as stamen. This male organ contains male gamete. This male gamete is present inside the pollen grains. The female organ is called as carpel. Carpel has the female gamete, and this female gamete is present inside the ovules. These ovules are also called as egg cells or ova. Now, male gamete present in the pollen grain will fertilize the female gamete present in the ovules. The fertilized egg grows within ovules and then it will become the seed. So, ovules become the seed. And ovules, when they get fertilized with pollen grains, then they will become the seeds. The seeds produce new plant in germination. When they germinate under suitable condition, they will give rise to new plant. Let us see next slide. So these are the parts of flowers. The base is receptacle. This is a base receptacle. Then this green is sepal. This red colored, very colorful, are petals. Then stamen, this part, yellow swollen part, and the stalk which is joining it to the flower is a stamen. And the central part is called as carpel. This entire organ is called as carpel. Carpel has three parts in it: stigma, style, and ovary. Inside ovary there are ovules. Carpels are also called as pistils. This entire part is called as pistil, and this entire part is called as stamen. Stamen has two parts, anther and filament. So this is the idea of parts of flowers. Let us see next slide. Male part and female part. Inside that male part, I have explained that stamen is entire is stamen, and top one is anther, and bottom this stalk is filament. In the female part, top is stigma, then middle part which is connecting the stigma and the ovary is the style. It is a tube-like structure, and The below part is ovary, and this contains small ovules inside it. This entire structure is called as carpel or pistils. Let us see next slide. Now this I have given in tabular form for you to understand it easily. Parts of flower, the structure of the part and the function which it carries out. Receptacle, this one is a broad base of flower. So how is the structure? It is a broad base. What is the function? All the parts of flower are attached to receptacle. You can see here ovary, stamen, pistil, sepals, everything is attached to receptacle. Next part is sepal. This green part is sepal. They are green leaf-like part and they are the outermost circle of the flower. And this sepals, all the sepals together are called as calyx. What is the function of this calyx? Calyx protects the flower when it is in its bud form. Then third is petals. Petals, they are colorful and they lie deep inside the sepal. First layer is sepal and the next layer is petal. All the petals together are called as corolla. And these petals are usually scented to attract the insects for pollination. Function. What is the function of the petal? Function, as I have said, they attract the insects for pollination. What is pollination? Pollination is transfer of pollen grains from anther to stigma. That is process is called pollination. Now, these petals, they also protect the reproductive organs which are at the center of the flower. This anther and stigma and ovary and all these are in the center of the flower, and petals, they protect the reproductive organs. Let us see next slide. Parts of flower, stamen is a male reproductive organ, and the little stalk with a swollen top inside the ring of the petal is called as stamens. These are stamens, and stamen produce pollen grains, and the stamen has two parts, anther and filament. So pollen grains are produced inside the anther. Functions: anther produce pollen grains and store inside it. What are the pollen grains? Yellow powdered like grains appear on the anther is a pollen grain. And this pollen grain, inside this pollen grain, there is a male gamete. Next part is carpel or pistil, that is a female reproductive organ. And it is in the center of the flower. And the carpel has three parts, stigma, style and ovary. Stigma is a top part, it is sticky. Style is a middle part. And ovary is the bottom swollen part because it has lots of ovules in it. So stigma receives the pollen grains. Because it is sticky, the pollen grains will stick onto it. The style is a tube connecting the stigma and ovary. And ovary makes and stores the ovules. Inside the ovary, ovules are produced and they are stored inside it. And this ovules, they contain the female gamete. So what happens in pollination? The pollen grain will pollinate it. So I hope you would have understood the parts of flowers. Like and share with your friends to score better marks. Subscribe my channel and thank you for watching my channel.